Yes, welcome back to Unbox My Life. Today, maybe we should open a package. Yeah, that's a good idea. Do I have any package? Oh, a Chinese package. Ah, that's nice. They maybe are nice. They can be a bit cheap, but okay anyway. So, yeah. And to open a package, I think we need a knife. And yes, maybe a Kershaw knife. So, let's see what this is. Ah, you already know what it is. Ah, it's so bad. I have to type it in so you can click the video and see the unboxing. But I almost maybe don't know what it is. So, but yeah, it should be a musical unboxing. Not just an unboxing, but yeah. I hope you are with me anyway. I like to unbox my life, yeah. So, what have we here? Oh, one of my favorite brand, Rovivon, yes. Ah, a rechargeable pen light, yes. This is the Aurora A33 rechargeable pen light. This is, I think, a small, cool pen light. And of course, I choose the Cree. And I choose the dark green because I like green. Yeah. And I think if you see my... Yeah, green and dirty floor, of course. So, why not choose a dark green light? And this have the LiPo, the 600 milliamps battery. Okay, here it says Type C rechargeable. I thought I should be complaining about the micro USB port, because on the homepage they say it is a micro USB port. So that's funny, because here it says Type C. So that's nice. I like the new Type C. The micro USB is out of date, as you can see. And I have some friends to come and join me. And this one is on charging. And that's cool. The power light is... The power button is shining up, and it's shining blue when it's ready. This is the A9 copper version. So I think this should be really nice patina on later on. So that's nice. And this is my small favorite, the A2. This has 550 lumens. I think this has 650 lumens. And this is the A25, the bigger brother. And this has around 1000 lumens. We should, of course, as usual, try them out in the Swedish darkness up here. But yes, let's continue. They have this in various colors, so I choose the green one. I think it looks really cool. And then they have these engravings in it for better grip, I think. But yeah, I don't know. I think it's cool. It's more cool. And they have this deep pocket carry-on clip that you can just take loose if you want. And you have this aluminium power button. I thought it should be a plastic rubbery button, but that's feel like a premium part. Ooh, shining. Okay, so it has the moonlight. And then I think it is low, medium, and high. So it's quite small, and if you compare it to the A2, it's kind of the same chassis, but of course longer. The A9 is a little bit thicker, so that's the same, as you can see. So yeah, it's a small pen light. It's, and I like this grip, so you can just flash like this. They call this grip like quick action, and the maximum output of this is 200 lumens. And I don't know really, it says 200 lumens, but then on high mode it says 220. So yeah, 20 lumens, I don't know. It's around 200 lumens for it, and I think that's really good for a small flashlight. And you have some battery time on it as well. 60 hours on the moonlight, 15 hours on the low, 5 hours on the medium, and 1 hour on 200 lumens max. I think that's okay, because it's a small pen. And you have this built-in battery. I don't... Oh, maybe we can open it. Oh, yes. Oh, look at that. That's really cool. Ah! That's really cool. That's the USB-C port. Of course. Sometimes I'm really stupid. This has to be like this because it's a IPX8 standard. So it's really waterproof. I don't know what IPX8 is, but I think it's like 1 or 2 meters under the water for a couple of hours, something like that. So that's really good. And of course you have to cover the port for that. That was cool. Okay, and you have to close it that way as well. Not today. And you have of course the small instruction manual, and this is the usual blade they have, and a really tiny USB-C cable, but you don't have to have a longer one, I don't think so. So that's okay as well. Operation momentary on, half press the button, release to turn off. You have like a two click button, but I don't think release to turn it off. Momentary on, half press button. Nothing happens here. Constant on, full press. Okay. I don't know if I have to charge it up, because this momentary on. I can't read. It's you can see, you can half press the button, and then you have the click, but nothing happens. Half press to change mode, and full press to select the brightness you need when the light is off. Yeah. Let's see the manual. Let's see the manual. It's nothing here on English. Chinese. That's nice. There you have the German. Klicken Sie bei jedem Status. Here you have the IPX8 standard classification. Underwater for 2 meters, 30 minutes. I said a couple of hours, but yeah. Don't use it underwater for so long. No mode memory from off. Long press to turn on from moonlight. Yeah, from any status, triple click to strobe. Ah, you have the 1, 2, 3 from status. Long press to turn off. Yes, of course. Channel 2 from off. Rapid double click to turn on from the memorized mode. Okay, yeah. That's normal for this one. Click to cycle through the birds. From any status, rapid triple click to strobe. But that's the... Okay, here is some other instructions. And on the internet, you have some other instructions. So it's two kind of instructions. Ah, I just use the flashlight like I always do. Double click to turn it on, and then you just click once to increase the power in it, to cycle through it, and then just hold it to shut it down. And that's the same to this one. Double click. I don't think we take this with in the test. We have 1000, 550 and 200 lumens. I think that's enough to just show the power in this small pen light. Yes, let's do it.
12 o'clock midnight.
Oh yes, welcome back to my testing grounds for flashlights. It's the same ground as always. Let's try the A33. You see, this is low mode, medium, and I think that's high. No, that's high. So you have moonlight. Moonlight, low, medium, high. So this is 200 lumens. And I think this is really okay. You can see the trees over there. And you have my nice wagon, I think, somewhere. There you have the wagon. Then you have the house over there. And some trees over there. You can't see, almost can see them. Oh, now it's snowing. And here you have this tree. So this is the 200 lumen pen light. It's quite good. And now we try the E2. Oh, it's windy. I hope that's not disturbing. Oh, it's getting stormy up here. So this is 550 lumens. Quite okay. There you have the wagon, the house up there, some trees behind it, I can't see it, and then this one. So 550. Ah, glows in the dark. That's nice. So this is the A25. Thousand lumens. Now you can see the tree and the wagon and the house, really good, and the trees behind there and the tree here. So this is 1000 lumens. So that's the difference. Let's try the pen light again, some like comparison. This is 200 lumens. It's okay. I think it's really good for that size.
Nice. So there you have it. The test of the A33. So do you have any comments or question? Just comment below. Hit the thumbs up for more videos like this one. And until next time, see you. Bye bye.